should start talking about cocktails. Cocktails, we just had lunch, but we should sit there and take a cocktail. Look around. A cocktail is actually quite interesting. There's a lot of technology. You need a sufficient amount of whiskey. You need a sharp knife to cut the orange. All kinds of things. You have to make sure that it's there. Finally, you sit down and you look over the seashore. And then on the horizon, you can see all kinds of targets and so coming up. Now, this crazy is going to tell you about the cocktail of technology, and all kinds of other things that have to come together in order to make things work. Let me first give you a short introduction about my company, Aqua Aero Water Systems. It was founded by me in 2002, and in 4 years' time, we were receiving the World Bank Prize for small-scale water innovation. And that was probably related to the fact that we always looked to the water problem out of a financial sustainable perspective. So if you introduce something, it should be financial sustainable. Not only sustainable, no. In the end, financial sustainable. Why? Because if you want to scale up, you shouldn't push, but you should pull. That's the trick behind it. At present, we are working with about 25 people, 5 people in the Netherlands, 15 in Indonesia, where we have a company, another one, 5 in India, and we're having different partnerships in Kenya, in Tanzania, Senegal, that type of things. The focus is on financial sustainable solutions in water and sanitation, and today I will be focusing on water. Just to give you some idea of what type of technologies we have been working on. This is called the water pyramid that was introduced by me. It's a giant dome, plastic. Inside you put saline water. Over time, during the day, it's getting heated up quite a bit and tickles down. And there you have this the clean water coming out. No energy needed. You just take the sun, off you go. And if it starts raining, you use it as a rain water harvesting event. And again, you can collect and you can purify and distribute. This type of issues we've been building all around Africa. This, for instance, in Gambia, Senegal, here in Rajasthan, where we had some fight with camels coming by, Indonesia, along the shores, island ridges, where we take water from the sea, pump it in the pyramid, let it desalinate, take it out, and people can consume it. And we also always were trying to find local resellers willing to buy the product and sell it to the market. Here, even at this is in Pamana Island in Flores, where people come, a guy comes with a funnel and he's buying about 50 liters. He's going from family to family to sell them water. Just to give you a short impression of the concept behind it. So we're producing drinking water at a very, durable, sustainable way. It is generating local entrepreneurship. It's also generating income, but more important, it's increasing your health. However, it was not as big as a success as we thought, because it appeared that the cost of the water was too high. And where we come at in local environments, often the water is subsidized by NGOs or by governments, and that's giving you a very big problem. So that was the reason why we also moved to different technologies. For instance, large-scale rainwater harvesting. Think about a tropical country where you have huge masses of rain coming down only in a very short time period. So the question is, how can you store it sufficiently? Up to now, people use normal large-scale concrete structures, but they crack open like this. Oh, sorry. Let me see. Yeah, they crack open. Wrong size, wrong type of materials. People, the masons do not have the capacities, and so on. So water flushes away. All kinds of animals get inside. We learn about diseases that's happening here. So that's the reason why not so much rainwater is being captured. And so we thought of a new system,
a sustainable system. Why not just dig a hole, put a wall inside, then take a giant bag, it's fully closed, put it into this hole, put a little roof on top of it over here, and you have stored about 50 cubic meters of water. Effectively, you can enlarge this to 100 cubic meters. So the water is taken from the roof, it's being filtered, the bag is fully closed so no animals can come inside. There you go. We are placing them in remote villages, schools, hospitals, that type of small clinics, and you just need to have corrugate. Some rainfall. In Rajasthan, it's about 500 millimeters per square meter per year, and sandy subsoil, and off you go. Well, but here's some people using it. This is in Senegal, in the south of Senegal. Actually, this is a nice picture, because it's showing you the same perspective during different times of the year. This is just after the rain season. And this is when it has been dry, fully dry for about five months. The funny thing, though, which I don't understand, is that here you would expect to have leaves, but here somehow leaves are there. It's not Photoshop, I can tell you. So when you get into a rainwater harvesting, you also want to purify. And we purify using a UV water box. It can purify up to 10,000 liters using solar systems. It's extremely simple. This is in Sierra Leone, where it's also applied with a number of local entrepreneurs. It's being applied at schools and so on. The water quality is excellent. You kill all the germs effectively and immediately. This is in Kenya. And also in India, office in Indonesia, where we set up a chain of toko ayers using the same type of systems to set up sustainable, financial sustainable systems. So this is a little bit about the background. Only one slide about our sanitation part. We talk about sanitation, we think it should be very practical. For instance, composting, on-site composting, but also sustainable composting. You take, you close the latrine, you make sure that it's 100% hygienic composted, and then you can apply it to give fertilizer. And if you don't like the smell of urine, you can make struvite out of it and sell it as a certain type of it's called fertilizer. Now let me get to the cocktail, because one day. It must have been somewhere in the autumn of 2014, we were called by Chordate, and they told me, listen, we are having a huge problem. We are one of the major NGOs in Holland. We are having about a budget of 188 million euro. We are working in 39 countries, but we are not able to get water projects sustainably done, especially in India. In India, you have about, you're all familiar with it, it's 1.3 billion people. The size of the BOP is about 900 million. 100 million are suffering from drinking dirty water, by which I mean it's saline, brackish saline, a lot of fluorine into it, arsenic, nitrates, everything. So, and the BOP, of the income of the BOP is about 2.2 euro a day. If you have to buy something from, let's say, 100 euro, you have to work 100 days or 50 days without earning a penny to buy a thing. So that is the perspective you have to start off with. The water stress in India is, of course, also very is massive. Huh? This area here, everywhere along the coastal areas, you have saline water intrusion, etc. So the question. Develop a financial sustainable system, water solution for the BOP in India. And with that, that was the starting point of our mission, starting from the autumn of 2014. And we thought of a certain region to start. Where? In Gujarat, because Gujarat is having about 55 million people working there. It's the groundwater is at the depth of about 1,000 meters. Saline water, brackish water, fluorine, everything is there. Big problem. And that's where we focus our watershed model. The watershed model, delivering water for the Indian BOP at locally acceptable prices, based on a financial sustainable business model. Now, what is the model consisting of? Let me try to clear that out to you. First of all, we are collecting the raw water. That is normally done like this here. This is the normal situation. We take it, we take care of storing it, and from there, we are going to purify. We purify using local systems and local technologies. We are using reverse osmosis in combination with a number of other filters, and we make sure that everything is being built and operated locally. Then we are going to store. It's being stored for 1 or 2 days. After that, the tank is being cleaned using chlorine. But simply, the storage is being handled manually and locally. And then after that, billing and distribution takes place. Well, I'm sure that when you entered this building today, you were given this RV card. We are using the same card for billing the people. Where is it? I'm showing it to you. It is over here. So the same card, which is handed out to people in India, you cannot imagine, but they're using it quite effectively. And actually, that has to do with marketing. We have been making sort of a credit card from it. Imagine that you are someone at the BOP and you're having your first credit card available. That's amazing. And on that card, a small amount of money is being placed. And every time when you come to the water shop, you just hold it to the eye. It's over here. And this eye indicates, okay, it withdraws a little bit of money from it and serves you with another 10 or 20 liters. Well, this is what it looks like. So people have a card, they just come, they buy the water, they take their own jerrycan with them, and off they go. But critical in this whole system is the e-based technologies that make the difference, because now that we have this card, we also can send as a message to a central system. And we can also we can also make sure that everything is being monitored, and we can make sure that corruption is being taken down, and quality control can take place. And this is how it works, of course, with solar panels and so on. So it's quite easy. Now, if you look to it as in terms of business model, everybody is paying, because you have to pay to buy a card. The water is sold at 0.6 euro cent per liter, at a very low low price. And from the third year onwards, we are gaining a positive cash flow. And the water shop itself is costing about 6,500 euros. The capex, that's the capex. Everything is being bought in India. And the loan, which is taken from private investors, is being repaid in 5 years' time. That's the cherry. Now, to give you proof of concept, because it's a nice model, we can talk models all day. You have to prove it as well. So from January onwards, we have been working on this. 10 shops have been built, 8 are working so far. We are producing 150,000 liters in August. 2,000 families are taking the water, and they like it. And they also are willing to buy the water. These are our customers. Lessons, the business model works. Customers are willing to buy. Locally, we select the technologies and apply it. And there are sensitive issues like partner selection and location selection. And the critical thing is online data collection, and make sure that you can control quality and all kinds of financial and administrative actions. And of course, the question, is there any interest in future funding? Yes. We have selected, we have now our first loan being taken care of. 200 shops will be there soon from now. I have only 1 minute left, I think. Okay, organization, because that's important. Local Indian partners. I can do this very rapidly. This one has been, this Indian partner has been working 8 years, being able to produce about 4,500 water factories. Important to scale up. We are talking about scaling up. You have to have the ability to scale up. If you don't know how to do it, forget it. Then we get to the local organization. That's important as well, because you need to provide a local system. Community has to come here. This is where the stirring of the cocktail takes place. Local entrepreneurs, they have to make money with it. And regional water authorities, they have to be happy, because otherwise they will kick you out. And finally, your water shop is taking care of the operations. And then you get the public-private partnership. Targets, within 2 years, about 200 water shops. In 5 years from now, 1,500 water shops. And we are looking to other places like Sierra Leone, Cameroon, and Nepal. Sit back, relax, take your cocktail. Thank you.